I was down in Music City about a week ago. I wanted to see the Grand Ole Opry show. So I hailed a cab and I headed down to Opryland. They said they had sold their last ticket the day before, so I kind of just hung around the backstage door. Then down the steps she came, man, oh man. My favorite female country star, she waved to her fans and headed for a car. Her tire, unlike her body, was very flat. She said, could you change my tire? I said, your wish is my desire. As she raised the lid, I grabbed her bumper jack. She said, I sure do appreciate you changing my tire. If I told you who it was, if I told you who it was, you'd say I was making it up. You've seen her on the screen and country magazine, you'd think I was making it up. She said it was our little secret, and by golly, I'm gonna keep it. Anyway, you wouldn't believe it if I told you who it was. She said, you need a lift, and I said, well, you can drop me off at the York Motel. So we headed down Briley Parkway into town. I told her, I've got all your records, ma'am. She smiled and said, well, I'll be down. Say, you're kind of cute, fella. Wanna mess around? When we got to my room, just to be polite, I said, sure wish I could have heard you sing tonight. She smiled at me and said, what you want to hear? Now, if I was one of them country music folks, I tell you, she'd sure get my vote for the best performance of the year. If I told you who it was, if I told you who it was, you'd say I was making it up. You've seen her on the screen and country magazine, you'd think I was making it up. She said it was our little secret, and by golly, I'm gonna keep it. Anyway, you wouldn't believe it if I told you who it was. But I'll tell you this much, when I put my arms around her and squeezed her real tight, she looked up at me with those big, beautiful eyes, took a deep breath and a sigh and said,
howdy! I'm just so proud to be here.
If I told you who it was, if I told you who it was, you'd say I was making it up. You've seen her on the screen and country magazine, you'd think I was making it up. She said it was our little secret, and by golly, I'm gonna keep it. Anyway, you wouldn't believe it if I told you who it was. For 2 long years, my head hurt bad, so the doctor checked me and he shook his head. He said, I'm sorry to tell you, but your body's outlived your brain. He said, I know this doctor in New York, son, and he'll fix you right up with a brand new one. So the head doctor met me when I stepped down off of the train. He said, we had this bank robber killed last night. His body shot, but his brain's all right. I'll give you a transplant, boy, and you'll be okay. I got my new brain in and I was feeling great. I went right back to Nashville with no headache, but something strange happened when I walked in the bank one day. I said, stick 'em up, everybody, I'm robbing this place. Drop all of your money in my guitar case. Don't nobody move and don't nobody reach for that door. A lady said, why, you're Johnny Cash. I said, no ma'am, I'm the Manhattan Flash, and I am the best bank robber in New York. Now the other night, Roy Acuff called me. He said, John, I'd like for you to do the Opry. So I went out on the stage, but I couldn't sing. I got into half a verse if I walked the line, and something snapped in this head of mine. I yelled, stick 'em up, give me your money, your watches and rings. Well, I called New York and talked to that brain quack. I said, Doc, I've got to have my old brain back. He said, I'm sorry there, Mr. Cash, but I can't do that. He said, I put your brain in a chicken last Monday. He's singing your songs and making lots of money. And I got him signed to a 10-year recording contract. Now, friends, if you see me walking down the street, remember what you see ain't necessarily me. And if I try to hold you up, don't pay me no mind. But when you got 10 bucks that you can blow, you ought to catch that Johnny Chicken show. He's doing fairs and concert dates all up and down the line. I said, stick 'em up, everybody, I'm robbing this place. Drop all of your money in my guitar case. Don't nobody move and don't nobody reach for that door. A lady said, why, you're Johnny Cash. I said, no, ma'am, I'm the Manhattan Flash, and I am the best bank robber in New York. Well, I don't pay any income tax. You don't pay tax on money you steal. You ought to catch that Johnny Chicken show. Chicken in Black.
The town of Awafria rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip, for the stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 and 19 more. 1 and 19 more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. He was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from their windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. Was about to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red had not cleared leather when a bullet fairly ripped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. The big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron. And he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. The big iron on his hip.